What up, bro? It's Keraa fucking Boogz. I'm here with Ron and Riches. I'm about to talk about my life a little bit, tell y'all about my music journey, where I'm at, where I'm, you know, how I've been going. Let's get into it, man. Been running laps around these niggas, no time to catch a break. Been walk around on these tracks, I'm probably losing weight. But I'm flipping packs and getting back, nigga, I'm moving weight. And I keep a scale on me, just case I bag a plate. If it's a problem, I'm sliding, and we do homicide. We bring you drama and trauma and leave you traumatized. I'm Gordon Ramsay in the stool when I'm cooking up. It'll take a lot out of me to leave me shooken up.
Nice, man. So, you know, finally, you know, glad to have you on the show. I'm very happy. Brooklyn artists and,
that's right,
you know, up and coming, one of the one and only Miss Keraa Boogz.
That's right.
Yes. So, you know, on my show, I'd like to get started with, you know, your foundation, your blueprint, why it's important. You know, it's important to my viewers and me because, you know, this can be your Bible.
Right.
For the future.
Right.
You know, and people want to know, you know, who Keraa was back in the day and how she got started. They can always look back and see your challenges, your journey,
right,
and your grind.
Well, so. I'm Keraa Boogz. I'm from Brooklyn, New York. I grew up in Kingsborough, PA. I was born at Interfaith St. John's Hospital, you know, right on the Atlantic. So the P's right there, not too far. Shout out to the P's, because they doing good. But I don't know. I grew up with my moms, my pops in the household. I was grew up with my stepfather. My pops, he got deported in Jamaica, so he out there. My stepfather was my pops, though. Like, he held shit down. So, you know, he really influenced me a lot, too, because, like, he was the man of the house. He taught me how to lead, you know? He taught me how to grind and put your own foot forward to get what you want. So, you know, that's why I be doing what I do. But music, it came, I've been doing music since I was real young. Like, when I was in, like, elementary school, I used to come up with little freestyles and shit like that. My moms used to be like, let me hear it, kick something. So, you know, I kick it to my moms, and she told me keep doing it. But it really wasn't a passion, because I was a basketball player. That's what I was doing. I was playing ball when I was young. Like, that was nice.
Position?
I played point. Like, I don't know, I played everything. I kind of was big for my age, so they had me center. I was doing all type of shit. Like, but, you know, I was nice. I went to CS21 right there in the star. I think that's the star, yeah. And I played ball. That school really taught me the fundamentals of basketball. For high school, I went to Thomas Jefferson. I played ball there. You know, I could have been pro. I'd be mad about that shit now. Like, I'm playing on the news and newspapers, all that shit. But, you know, I lost my passion for that. And then as I grew up, everybody I knew, a lot of people in my family do music. So now I'm going to the stool a lot. I'm in the atmosphere, like, you know, networking with people. So I was just like, yo, I really like this shit. This shit fun. So I was like, let me do it. And nice. Then I just started doing that, like freestyling on beats, putting it into a song. That's how it started.
Nice. So what some artists, you know, most people have an artist that they study, you know, and they kind of follow. Who's your artist, both old school and new school, that you kind of follow today?
I ain't even gonna lie, I had an era where I was a big Nicki fan. Nicki, top five, she's definitely in my top five. Like, Nicki, yeah, I still know all her lyrics, word for word. It's crazy, but I go crazy with her. I love Lil Wayne. I feel like he, you know, he real intellectual. He know how to put shit together. Like, I don't know, he flips certain words back to back. You know, his mind, his creativity is out there. So it makes me look at him a lot. I love him.
Like, you know, a lot of people don't know that, but Wayne actually went to art school.
Yeah.
And, you know, he actually took pride in his education. So during the day, he was in the studio, sometimes at night. Bossy took a lot of night classes in art school to learn more metaphors, similes.
Right, right.
And that's how Carter 3 became the album.
That was a dope album. I made a reference to that in one of my songs. I love that album.
What reference did you make?
People coming and going crazy like the Carter 3 nigga. That nigga went crazy.
So the foundation, man, like, you know, so your mom, your stepdad,
yeah,
you know, basically, you know, raise you in a way.
Right.
And what's their, like, I'm guessing, like, their morals and ethics that they instilled into you?
But my mom, she was real strict. Like, I used to be scared of my mom. I could hear her keys, house keys, and I'd be panicking. But she really taught me to like stay true to myself, you know, don't follow nobody, don't be a leader, you know, have a brain of my own. I don't know, I'm real strong and independent because of her. I know that for a fact. I don't know, as far as like doing, I just been always positive. Like, I do everything real genuine, so I've never really had a problem, like, you know, stuff like that. I just grew up with manners. I'm real like, got consideration for people. You know, a lot of people don't think about shit like that, and I'm real empathetic, so I could walk in people's shoes and I could feel for others. You know, I grew up like that. We had a real nourishing household, bro.
So, like, how important it is, you know, for him as individuals to learn how to care for others and not try to, like, keep up a strong, you know, like, a strong wall.
Yeah, nah, it's real important because you never know what the next person going through. So, you know, you out here walking around or talking down on other people, you don't know. Like, you just, it's just, I think you should just do it at all times. You know, make the world a better place. For real.
Right. So, your music journey.
Mm-hmm.
When was the first time you put that pen to the pad?
Well, like I said, I was young. I was, like, in, like, fourth, fifth grade. But I didn't take that serious. But it was like a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, where I put a song on iTunes. My first song was called Humble Soul. Humble Soul, that's the reference to Lil Wayne that I had in there. And, you know, I realized that I got my own sound. Like, it's real soulful. You know, it's not like the drill with people into. It was real, you know, I like to feel the beat and talk my shit to the beat, you know?
Right.
And I don't know, it's real, music is kind of funny because, you know, when you're not living a certain way or you don't got certain shit, it's hard to rap about shit that you ain't come from, you know, like, so I don't try to fabricate too much, like, I try to stay true to myself and my music, like, for real. But, you know, I grew up in the trenches, so a lot of shit that I really know, like, I don't know.
So, you know, the authenticity
of music.
So, you know, why is it important for people to actually talk about their life rather than, you know, be told, talk about, like, certain subjects because it's popular?
I mean, it's real therapeutic. Music is therapeutic in a way. Like, I use it as therapy. Like, when I'm feeling a certain way about certain shit, I probably start writing about the shit. And then now, you know, so it'll make you real settled. Like, you don't do too much. For real.
Nice. So, the world today.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what you thought, you know, about the Roe versus Wade, a situation that happened?
Wait, what you mean?
You know, what they was doing with trying to take women's rights, things like that.
Oh, yeah, that was, I don't know, like, that's, I don't know. Well, women should have rights. Like, how you gonna take away our rights? We fucking, you know, we control this shit. It should have been a woman president. Shit.
You right.
For real. I'm getting bit up like a motherfucker. We gotta go somewhere.
Let's go. So, your next upcoming articles and your music, mm-hmm. What you got in the works for people to listen to and for people to hear?
Well, I made a song with one of my friends. That's my, like, one of my right hands because we do music together. Her name's Snoop Lokane. I got a song called Breaking the Rules with her. That shit on iTunes and it's on YouTube. So y'all need to go check that shit out. You know, I got another song. I got a couple songs on iTunes. I got something called Go Crazy, I made by myself. And another song, Humble Soul, I made by myself. I got a video to Humble Soul on YouTube too. But, you know, like I said, I started 2 years ago. I got a lot of songs. I feel like I just gotta put my work in more to, you know, go to the stool and make my visuals. Cause that's would make me like my songs more too, seeing the visuals to the, mm-hmm. the shit. Word.
So the dedication, right, mm-hmm. to, you know, an artist who's, you know, who working 9 to 5,
right.
who don't have the back end, mm-hmm. of, you know, of a big OG or a music mecca like
Atlantic
Records.
Mm-hmm.
So what is the journey like from you, you know, working every day, you still got to live a real life?
Right, that shit, that's like one of the, it's a pros and cons to that because like on your free time, you don't got nothing else to do but work on your craft, you know, so that you could perfect it. So it keep me busy a lot of times, but it's fucked up because like certain times I can't take over work when the engineer write me and be like, yo, I only got a session at 12, you know, and I can't make it because I get off at 12. So You know, shit like that. That'd be fucking my shit up. And then, like, financial situation, that I take care of my priorities first. Like, all my responsibilities, I pay all my bills, everything on auto pay. So, all that's first. And then, whatever is next, that's what I, you know? So, that's why I don't be going crazy either, because that shit is a lot, nigga. I'm still living. I still pay rent, car, no, all that. So, it take time. Unless, shit, somebody get a fucking miracle, or you got a friend that scam, or, you know, somebody helping you. But when you doing this shit by yourself, you gotta take your time. I don't really want to rush nothing, because I want my shit to be perfect. So I don't care how long it's going to take. I'm going to take my time. I'm going to do it when I want to do it. You know? That's how it is.
Nice. But, and like, what keeps you motivated every day to keep on grinding it out and, you know, not knowing when it's going to happen?
Right, right.
What keeps you motivated every day?
You know what's so crazy? I know my potential. Like, I just feel I got potential, like, doing this shit. And I'm real confident in myself. And then when I first started doing it, my fans is people that I don't know.
I do what I want, nigga, do what you do, can't walk on my shoes. I'm stepping for real and I'm stepping in loose. I'm breaking her back. I'm fucking her good, I put her to snooze, nigga, that's your bitch. I'm telling you now, you don't want her to.
So it make me look at shit differently. It make me be like, you know, maybe if you keep going, you would blow up. Like, you know, just have faith. I think that's all that plays a part in it. Mm. And then you really gotta work toward what you want. Like, put your mind to it. Cause when I first started, I had like a showcase with DJ Drewski and different A&Rs and shit. And that was like 2 months after. So it's like, when you see shit, you gotta go for it. I mean, I had to invest into it, cause I had to pay to get into it. But fuck it. Like, if you gonna invest into yourself, you gotta do that. For real. Mm.
Nice, nice. And what's some words of wisdom that you live by?
Don't stop, keep going. Never give up. Nah, I really be just, I be talking about myself, like and a lot of my songs at the end, I just like say, you know, don't stop. Niggas be hating, niggas be doubting me, I'ma blow. Like, just have faith in myself. That's really what it be. I don't really have a specific thing. I just stay true to myself. Or,
so what can you say to people who's like want to start music but don't know where to start? Who's in position, you know, they feel stuck because they don't have the proper people to support them or the proper team to really back them. What can you say to that?
You really just gotta do it. Like, you really just gotta just do it. Fuck it. Fuck everybody. Just on your alone time. Do what you do. Get in your vibe, your comfortable, like, whatever make you comfortable to create. Do it, post it, and then stay consistent with it. You feel me? I need to take that, because I'm not consistent. I'm not really into social media how I should be, but once I really, you know, lock in, that's all you gotta do. Lock in and do it. And just keep the faith in yourself. Everybody, once, I feel like when you believe in yourself, more people gonna believe in you too. So that's really what you gotta do.
Nice. Where can people find your music?
Come on.
Where people can hit you up, they wanna talk to you, you know?
Yeah.
Or mentorship or, you know, big sister advice, where can people reach out to you?
Well, my Instagram's Keraa Boogz, my TikTok Keraa Boogz _, my Facebook Keraa Boogz, everything, you know, Keraa Boogz. But my email, KeraaBoogzMusic@gmail.com, if anybody wanna like feature with me or send beats, anything like that. And my music is really on all platforms. Like, when I put my shit out, I put it out on all platforms. I think it's like over 150 platforms, but I mainly tell people iTunes, cause you know, you go right on your phone, you play for your car, all that. And then YouTube to get my views up on my video, you know, shit like that.
Nice, nice. Well, you know, I appreciate you. Freestyle?
I got something for you.
You know.
Look. Damn, I want a beat.
Yeah, put the beat out. Yeah.